A bizarre twist in the case against the woman accused of aiding her husband in the 2016 shooting rampage at that Pulse nightclub in Orlando, Florida. A massacre, that left 49 people dead. Attorneys for Noor Salman are calling for a dismissal of charges or a mistrial following new revelations about the father of the Pulse gunman. According to a motion filed by the defense, Sadiq Mateen was a confidential FBI source from 2005 through June 2016. Mateen is currently under investigation for money transfers from Turkey and Afghanistan after documents were found in his home on the day of the Pulse attack. Let's discuss this with CNN law enforcement analyst, former FBI supervisory special agent Josh Campbell. Josh, what impact, if any, do you think this will have on the case?
Well, I think it's going to be a distraction. I can't see it being anything beyond that. Obviously, the government has some answers that they need to provide as far as why the delay, why was this information only now being provided. But I think it would be challenging for anyone to accept the fact what the defense is essentially saying here. Their two points are, because the father was an FBI informant, that somehow that means that he was conspiring with Omar Mateen instead of her, which doesn't make any sense. The second point that they're trying to make is, you know, because he was an informant and the FBI and the government didn't provide that information, they're going after her in order to hide their own failure, which again makes no sense. So it's the old adage, if you can't attack the facts, you attack the government. Obviously, the government has answers they need to provide, but I don't see this impacting the case long term.
But why did it take so long for the government to provide this information to the defense that the shooter's father was an FBI informant?
Well, it's a very good question, and we are owed those answers as far as why that information was withheld. It's incumbent upon the government to provide that type of information to the defense so that they can, you know, prepare and try to state their case. But again, remember where this information came from and how we found out about it. The government told us. So if it was human error, we need to know about that. If there was some other reason for the delay, we need to know about that. But I don't think that we should ascribe any type of malicious motive right now.
And the money transfers coming in from Afghanistan and Turkey, the information was discovered in his apartment. What does that bring to the table?
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, if you look at some of the reporting, I mean, it was a voluntary interview, a consent search, where the information was discovered. So I don't see it as, you know, him actually trying to hide anything at the beginning. Why would he let the government in, you know, based on a consent? That'll be part of the investigation. Why did these funds go over? And I'm not saying that he's pure as a, you know, the wind-driven snow here. I'm just saying that it is pretty ridiculous for her to state that she's innocent because he may not be a pure person.